Hey, what's up, video editors? It's Premier Gal here, and as you may have guessed from this video intro, in this video, I'm going to teach you how to add some old school 90s inspired effects to your video in Premiere Pro, as well as add some edgy ProductionCrate overlays to create a rad 90s style music video. Now, ProductionCrate has heaps of visual and sound effects you can add to your videos. When you're at ProductionCrate.com looking at overlays or effects, you can see if an effect is free if they do not have a star next to it. If it does have a star, that means that it requires a pro membership, which is only $39 per year. So here from ProductionCrate.com, you can download the edgy overlays you would like to use in your video. All right, so let's head over to Premiere Pro. Here in my timeline, I have 90s inspired stock video of compact cassette players, cassettes with the magnetic tape coming out, guitar players, and more, all of which I got from Pond 5. I also have my logo reveal animation and some text I created with the Essential Graphics panel, and I downloaded a grungy font for this video. It's called HVD Rowdy. I put a link in my description box below. Now, none of the videos in my timeline have effects or overlays on it. So first, I'm going to add some posterize effects to the footage to give it more of an edgy and old school feel. First, go to Effects, search for Posterize, and under Stylize, drag and drop the Posterize effect onto the first video clip. Immediately, you see the colors look different, and it kind of looks bad. But in our case, that's what we want. If I turn the effect on and off, you can see the difference. So this Stylize Posterize effect, what this does is limit the amount of color that can be displayed. It converts the images we see into limited flat areas of tone and color. There is also a second posterization effect I will add to the clip, and it's called Posterize Time. Let's drag and drop this on the clip. Now under Effects Controls, we can customize this effect to reduce the number of frames in the video without actually reducing the speed of the video clip to make it look a bit older. So right now this clip is 29.97 frames per second, so let's cut this frame rate in half by typing in 15 here, next to the posterized time effect. And play it back and you can see it's more jolty, but let's turn it off and play it back and here you can see it's more smooth. Now turn the effect back on again and now you can see it just appears more unnatural and from a different time period. So let's apply these effects to all the video clips. Just right click on this clip and hit copy. Now let's lasso and select all the other video clips in the timeline we want to apply these effects to. Right click and select paste attributes, and let's paste the two posterize effects, and now all the clips are posterized. Now, when we play it back, it looks good, but we can make it even more edgy by adding in some ProductionCrate overlays on top of the video footage. So here in the project panel, I have a folder of all the overlays I downloaded from ProductionCrate. If I double click on an overlay, you can see in the source panel that I created an endpoint or a start point just by pressing I, and then I created an out point, the end point of the clip, by pressing O. Now I'm going to drag the overlay on top of the footage, and I'm going to use the rate stretch tool to change the duration and slow down this portion of the overlay to my desired length in the timeline. I set markers here in my timeline indicating the durations that I would want for each edgy overlay. And you can see that the stock video is already beneath because these effects have an alpha transparency layer, so there's no need to play around with blend modes. So now I'm going to drop in overlay number 2, and now this overlay has a 4K resolution, and since I created a 1920 by 1080 sequence, I'm going to have to scale this down. To do this, I'm going to right-click and select Scale to Frame Size. Now I'm just going to quickly fast forward as I drop in the rest of the overlay clips here on top of the video and adjust the duration and size just like I did with these first two clips. Now for this particular geometric overlay, I actually applied a Fast Color Corrector effect to change the color hue to be more purple. So I adjusted the hue angle to 107 and now the overlays are more purple. Now if I play it back, you can see that the video pretty much has the edgy old school feel that I was going for. But if you want to add some icing on the cake, I used a few plugin transitions to give it that extra edge. No pun intended. At the beginning here, I dropped in the FilmImpact TV Power Transition to the front end of both the overlay clip and the video clip. And so when you play it back, it looks like an analog TV is being turned on. Then on the text layers, I added a BorisFX Continuum cross glitch transition to the front of the first word and then to the end of the music video text. I also just copy and pasted that effect to the front end and the back end of the YouTube text, as well as used it as an outro for all the layers at the very end of the video. Now, if I play it back in those areas, you can see that they animate in and out with that slight glitch, and it added more dynamism, which helped pull your viewer in to the scene that you're trying to create, which is the 90s feel. Lastly, I added the BorisFX cross glitch effect to my logo reveal, and as you see in my effects controls, I keyframed this glitch intensity in and out to give it the look that I wanted. So that's all I have today. If you want more video tutorials that explore Production Crate or different genres of videos, give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment below. Also, be sure to head over to patreon.com/premieregal. If you become my monthly patron, you can get some fun perks, and also your donations help me continue to make free video content like this on my channel. So, special shout out to all my patrons so far, it means a lot. Be sure to click on my profile photo on the left to subscribe to my channel. Below that, you can click on my contact button if you want any custom video work done for yourself or company, or if you want a personal one-to-one training. Also, you can click on another video on the right to learn something new. Thanks again for watching, stay creative, and I'll see you all very soon.